Oh, it's backwards. Oh my God. Vanity is the name of the game. What do you think?
Pivot.
On fire. Today's a good day. Hello.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for watching this week's episode of Tools of the Trade. My name is Jonathan. This is Noodle. And this is my living room wall. And this is what we call my Tuscan kitchen table because it's made of tile and is beautiful enough that it looks like it could be in Tuscany. So we are filming live in my apartment in New York City and it's a blast, we're making it work. The name of the game the past few months has been Pivot and that's what we did. We lugged all this filming equipment up to my fifth floor apartment. Noodle obviously did all of the labor. He's clearly resting right now. We have him stacked. Usually we have a table, like a full desk. And we've got like normal seats and he's got like a whole little setup and we have really just pulled this out of our ass. Oh, my roommate just got home. Hi, Katie.
Hello.
So this week's box was curated by entrepreneur Sarah Funk. And I think a lot of you probably know Sarah Funk because she hosts our School of Hustle show right here on YouTube. I'm gonna indicate, this is indicating my surrounding frame of the YouTube platform. She hosts her School of Hustle, but she's done so many other things as well. So she has a very popular website called sarahfunky.com and she owns her own tourism company in New York City and she gets paid to travel the world and enjoy the splendors of this planet. Not only does she get to enjoy these experiences, but she's one of those people who she really does it for the benefit of others, I'm sure. She enjoys herself too, but she really does it to build these incredible guides. And if you go to her website, you'll see, she has a big YouTube channel as well. And there was one video she posted that I thought was very helpful. It was about New York City tourist traps, which is something that a lot of people don't know. So a lot of people, when they come to New York City for the first time, they're like, oh, I wanna see Times Square, I have to go. Don't. Avoid it at all costs. It is the armpit of New York City. It's the Albany of New York City. Okay, so we're gonna get into this box again. It was curated by Sarah Funk. Let's see. Oh, it's backwards. Oh well, we're rolling with it. Here we go. So it's a Sarah Funk box. Okay, so I don't know. Okay, so I don't know what this is, but I picked it first because I really like it. Oh, so it's just a dog toy. Okay, so I think this is for two things. So it is a dog, it's a MetroCard dog toy. This is very easy for me. So I think she loves dogs. I think she's a dog person. So I think this definitely represents a really important tool for any entrepreneur. Obviously in New York City, you can take cabs, you can take cars, you can walk. But the subway, at least in 2019, the subway was the best way to get around the city. And it's super easy, it's super convenient. It's kind of gross. You know, always leave one headphone out, but otherwise you're in the clear. What do you think? What do you think? He rides the subway. I put him in his little bag. And he's nice and quiet until a lady walks by with loud high heels and then he screams at her and scares the shit out of everyone on the train. Thank God he's cute. The next item we've got in the Sarah Funk box is the Blue Guide for New York City. Blue Guides were launched in 1918, founded by Scottish brothers James and Findlay Muirhead. I think this is just a travel guide. I think this is a travel guide of important buildings. Oh yeah, it's everything. You guys, this is a guide that has absolutely everything in it. So this is a really cool guide for anyone who's headed to New York City, either for the first time or who's lived there for a very long time and is just trying to find some new stuff to do. The next item we've got in the Sarah Funk box is L'Oreal Infallible Pro Sweep and Lock Translucent Setting Powder. This is important for anyone who's on camera. Setting powder is a great way, you're not fully baking your face, but setting powder is a great way to keep yourself from sweating, to keep your tone even. Sarah's out and about. She's always on camera. She's always doing something like this. So I think it's not just having the powder, it's probably that it's super portable and that she can bring it with her. And it's a sign of a professional. Just imagine, you're in New York City, you are a celebrity in New York City like Sarah Funk is. She's walking around and someone from her travels in India come up and they say, oh my God, Sarah, I haven't seen you in years. You know, the last time I saw you, we went on an ayahuasca vision quest. Let's get a photo. And her face hasn't been powdered. Imagine, just throw yourself into traffic. Not Sarah, she's ready to go. Vanity is the name of the game. The next item, I believe this is, I don't think this is just lipstick. I believe that this is probably a signature color of Sarah's. I like the idea that, is that a yes? So the way that this works is they send me the box, I don't know what's inside of it, and then I pick it out, try and figure out what it's for, and then Chris will either tell me yes or no. So I'm just kind of, this is really a fun game for me. Sarah's always got a red lip on. And I also think this has to do with confidence. Like lipstick, you know, a lot of people have their glosses, but I think lipstick is something that is like a real, you know, when I think of lipstick, I don't really think it matters what I think of lipstick, but like I would always, my mom would always be like, get my lipstick out of my bag. And I'd be like, oh, she's going to get her bottle of wine. People put their lipstick on when they've got like a real, like I've got an intention and whether the intention is I just want to feel good, or the intention is I want to catch someone's eye, or the intention is I was born without pigment in my lips. Again, I think it speaks to confidence. I think it speaks to being on camera as often as she is. And it's an individual thing. This color is called On Fire Red. This is on fire, it's on fire, The last item we've got in the Sarah Funk box. Oh my God, I have, yes. It's a Fire 7. Sarah loves to read, but what makes this so incredible is not just that it's designed for entertainment, which it says on the back, but she travels all the time. She travels across the world. I can't tell you how many times I've been in the middle of nowhere with no hope of getting home, and I've needed a book. This is a really cool portable tablet, and I think it makes sense for not only someone who owns her own business, but owns her own travel business and does equal parts showing people the world and the city and the stuff around her, and then also getting to enjoy it herself. And that's it. That's it. That's, oh, good morning. Hello. Hello. That is the Sarah Funk box. I am so excited by the things that I saw inside of it, not just because I got a good idea of who she is as like an entrepreneur. Obviously, we know she runs her travel business, but these tools that people curate are always giving me such a good idea into like what these entrepreneurs prioritize or what they need to have on hand. Cause it's one thing, you know, obviously she runs, you know, a YouTube account. She's probably got a beautiful camera. She's probably got a camcorder. She's probably got really nice headphones or a microphone or something like that. But these items are the things, the actual travel guide, the powder, the lipstick, and the Kindle, these little elements are things that she really, really needs to get through her day, whether it's a normal day or it's a May 2020 day and no one knows what's going on. She's really done a wonderful job of adapting, and we're so grateful not only to have her as a part of our family, but to have her as someone who curated a box for tools. If you liked this video and you want to see more of the inside of my apartment, you'll probably see another video like this. So please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget to ring the bell to get notifications whenever a new episode of Tools or School of Hustle or Made in America, one of our many series, goes live. And I think my tip for this is gonna be, if you're ever given the opportunity to offer to help somebody carry camera equipment up 4 flights of stairs, say no. Say you can't. That's it, that's my tip. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.